Do you worry that because plan A for Russia perhaps hasn't gone as well as they were hoping, and because of the nature of Putin and to a certain extent the nature of Russia as a result is that, you know, Russia doesn't lose, because of that, the warfare is going to get, you know, get more dirty, get bigger, get more aggressive, get nuclear even?
Yes, we need to brace ourselves for that. We've had incredible results. The Ukrainians themselves all stepping forward. They've certainly hampered the Russian timetable, but we must brace ourselves for an escalation in this war. My concern is, as you imply, it's not beyond Putin to stoop to radical tactics to secure victory. He cannot afford to fail. And we need to ask ourselves those very, very difficult questions. At what point does the international community continue to watch from afar? We've benched the nuclear, our NATO deterrent from outside. They've shored up the NATO family of membership, but we've yet to actually set foot in the country itself. Understandable why that decision has been made. There was a call that I made 6 months ago to say we should have sent troops in. But ultimately, as things are moving very, very fast, you have to ask yourself, what is Putin trying to achieve here? Where will he go to next if we don't step in?
What did you make of Foreign Secretary Liz Truss's comments this morning about this conflict potentially going on for 10 years?
I'd like to see more about that analysis, that assessment. What I would say is I think we're experiencing a turning point in our history at the moment. What we're seeing is we have entered a dark chapter in European affairs. State-on-state open warfare is returning to Europe again. We've not seen that since 1968 with tanks rolling into Czechoslovakia. And we're now appreciating and realizing that what happens in Ukraine actually affects the rest of European security and stability as well. But I'd go further than that to say that the last 30 years that, I think you and I are old enough to remember the Cold War, but, you know, we've been lucky. We've been fortunate, this peacetime period. That isn't the norm. And we're now, the world is now resorting to type, if you like, where authoritarian states are willing to use brute force to further their own agenda. And during that last 30 years, we have become a little risk averse, a little timid, a little, you know, perhaps forgetting what it takes to stand up to defend our values. So there's an awful amount of regrouping that needs to take place. Confirmation that, yes, we need to be more resolute in defending our hard-fought standards and values.